Thanks for clicking on News-Sentinel.com. I'm Multimedia Specialist Justin Kenny here with renowned columnist Reggie Hayes. We are week 7 of the high school football season, moving right along the final third of the 9-week regular season. Really crunch time for a lot of teams. Some big games coming up, including this week. Some big it's kind of rivalry week, especially in the SAC with games. And we're going to start right off at with Carroll Homestead, the newbies of the SAC, so to speak, but obviously a storied rivalry in the NHC. What do you see in this one?
Well, you know, that's what I do like, the fact that they both came in the SAC, so they brought that rivalry with them. And Carroll has been really impressive of late to me. I mean, I think since their loss to Snyder that they've really notched it up. They've gotten better and better offensively. Defensively, maybe there's still some ways you can attack them, and maybe Homestead's going to try to exploit that with their combination of Jordan Presley and some other things. So I still think Carroll is playing better than Homestead right now.
You mentioned that Snyder game of 41-7 loss week 2. Since then, 49 points, 62 points, 36, and then 62 again against South last week, averaging over 42 points a game with that 7-point game against Snyder factored in. So are you kind of surprised that the Carroll offense has been as explosive as it has?
Well, I think there are a lot of new pieces this year in the quarterback situation and things that we didn't know what we're going to see. But to put up those consistent numbers, and you can take that Snyder game out because Snyder is very good defensively.
Yeah.
And I think they caught them on a night when Snyder was strong. Carroll wasn't as strong as they could be. They play again. I don't know that that would be quite as large a margin, but I think it's a credit to Carroll and their program that they're able to reload their offense and get it moving like they have right now.
Homestead's no slouch either, 4-2. Their losses to DeWanger and Snyder, no problem with that. They rebounded with a 48-0 win over Northside last week. This could be a sectional preview because most years these two teams meet in sectional 3 in 6A. So you look at this game, is it as important with a likely rematch coming in sectional play, or is it something where you kind of play it safe a little bit?
Yeah, that's a good question. I don't know that you, at this point in the season, if they were meeting week 9 and then again in the sectional, it'd be a different situation. But I don't think you really hold anything back. I do think Homestead's going to have to show that they can score some points against a good defense, because most of their success has come against some a little bit of a weaker defenses. This week they'll face a good one, maybe not a great one, but a good one. And they've got to find some ways to get on the board, because Carroll, as we just mentioned, can score points in a hurry.
Yeah, you mentioned just 13 points against DeWanger, 17 against Snyder. Homestead needs to find to get score some consistent points against some good teams. The other big one, the Battle of the Bishops over at Lewis Field, DeWanger and Lewis. We start with DeWanger, 2-game losing streak. They need to get back on track.
They do, and I think we mentioned offensive needs for Homestead, and DeWanger has that too. I think 21 points isn't bad the last couple games, but they were scoring a little bit better earlier in the season. I do think that, you know, as Clark has gotten back, and you tell me, is he healthy now?
I think he's getting close to 100%. I don't think Coach Schwarzkopf would say he's at 100%. But
he's such a weapon for him,
yeah.
And he's such a dynamic player in a lot of ways, and I think if he's at his peak, then they can do so many more things offensively that I think that would kick them into gear. Lewis can score points. We've seen that. I mean, look at the numbers they're putting up. Their defense is not necessarily very good.
Yeah, they need to score points.
I mean, what was 49 points last week that Northrop scored? And I don't know if all of those were offensive points, but those are a lot of points to score. So defensively, Lewis is not particularly strong right now, and DeWanger has to be able to exploit that.
I think it's a get-healthy week for DeWanger, and they absolutely need it with Snyder coming up week 8. You don't want to say must-win, of course, but they really need some positive vibes, positive momentum, because we looked at that week 8 game against Snyder as the deciding factor of the SAC. Now that's not really the case, so they really need to get some positive momentum going.
Yeah, and this is a game that comes at a good time, I think, for both teams as they get ready for that final stretch before the playoffs. Because it's a natural rivalry game. I can't say rivalry very well.
We can spell it better than we can say it. That's why we're writers.
But it's a natural game between two longtime foes. Let's put it that way. But I think this is a good time for both of those teams, because you'll get up for the game regardless. It doesn't matter what the records are when DeWanger and Lewis are facing off. And it'll be a great crowd, I'm sure, over at Lewis. So.
Bishop Lewis, they have a 2-game winning streak. They have Southside week 8 and then the Snyder game week 9. You mentioned that defense and what they need to do. Do you feel this is a defense that can improve over the final 3 weeks, or is it going to be a fact where they just need to outscore teams?
I'm going to go with the latter of outscoring teams, because generally speaking, when you get this deep in the season, either you've got a good defense or you don't. I don't know that it gets a lot better at this point in the season unless you have certain injuries, and I'm not in tune to lures to know if there are players that haven't been 100% on that defense that would give them a boost. Otherwise, I think they're just going to have to go out and score more. And they can score more than a lot of teams they play.
Yeah, definitely. And with so many guys going both ways for Bishop Lures, we talked about it all year, that roster a little bit smaller than usual. It's naturally tough for guys to go out there and play 70, 80, 90 snaps. They need to get a breather at some point. So, right. Maybe it's an approach where Kyle Lindsey said, look, I'm going to need these guys offensively, and I need to rest them a little bit, at least defensively, because he knows he has a prolific offense and they need to score points.
Right.
The other big rivalry game, I'll say it so you don't have to, game. North and South, they play for the totem pole once again, and two down programs right now, but I think, to be able to win that totem pole is a big kind of a feather in your cap regardless of what your final record is.
Yeah, you go back to talking about these other games. They're just games that naturally get you to play your finest, and this North versus South is going to be one of those. And I think that North side has the one win, right, between the two of them against a good Wayne, decent Wayne team.
Yeah.
So they have some potential to be a strong team on any given night. And Southside has its issues, but I do think that both teams have some playmakers that could make a difference. And this game could be a tight game where it does come down to who makes that special play.
Yeah, Dennis Johnson, quarterback for Southside, very underrated just because the Archers are 0-6. But this is a series that kind of goes in spurts where South will win a lot in a row, then North does South. And right now North kind of has won the last three or four, I think, is what the streak is. So that'll be over at Chambers Field on Friday night, North versus South. Step over to the NE8. The big game, obviously, next week, East Noble and New Haven. Does New Haven kind of look ahead a little bit, do you think? Or do you think this team, you've seen them this year, I've seen them this year, different kind of team. They're really focused, zoned in 1 week at a time.
Well, I think that they've got great team chemistry this year, and that wasn't the case last year even, that they've got going on at New Haven. I think things are really have gelled together for that program. You've got seniors who do a good job of leading. With Keyshawn Moore, he's stepped into a senior role that's really special. I mean, he's been able to leadership role, that is, that he's able to take on. I do think that if you look at their last three games, the score has been 154-15. You say, okay, well, they played some poor teams, Norwell, Columbia City, Leo, which is a little bit down this year. But on the other hand, that's putting it up. I mean, that's making sure sometimes you play against teams that aren't quite as strong and you'll end up maybe not having that same energy level to put up those kind of numbers, but they have. And I know that Coach Rowland's going for his 100th career win this week, so I'm sure his players would like to get that for him.
Definitely. You mentioned the defense. We talked so much about the New Haven Bulldogs offense, but just 15 points the last 3 weeks. Other than that Lakeland game week two where they surrendered 26, a lot in junk time, they've posted 0, 9, 6, and 0. You look forward to next week's game, which is obviously two dynamic offenses. That could be the difference, the way this New Haven defense is playing.
Yeah, and they haven't faced – I don't think they faced somebody like East Noble. So when they do get to that game next week, that will be a challenge for them because they haven't been really necessarily prepped, although you would assume that their defense, at least the ones that aren't going both ways, have seen some great playmakers during practice against their first team offense.
Definitely. Belmont's just a pesky team. Obviously, they had the success last year. Only lost by 10 to Leo, 3 points to South Adams, a 10-point game against Adams Central. So 2-4, but a little bit misleading.
And in past seasons, Belmont, even when they haven't had a good team, have found a way to win that one game nobody expected them to win and to put it all together that one night. So that's something New Haven has to watch out for.
For sure. Final stop this week, South Adams and Jay County. I think I saw South Adams last week. Expected a closer game against Adams Central last week. It was 45-14 was the final. But I think South Adams, they get Jay County this week. Then they get Woodland. Of course, they want to kind of put a scare into Woodland before that week 9 game, Woodland and Adams Central for the ACAC. But you think South Adams is going to be able to recover pretty well?
You've got to flush that one. I mean, they went into that game with the rival, and they have had some momentum going into that game, and Adams Central just showed that they are a superior team. And Adams Central and Woodland, have definitely separated themselves from the rest of the ACAC. This game really is the two next best teams, I would say. And Jay County has lost two of their last three, but then they played against those powerful teams as they've gone down to this stretch of the season. So I think this game really is a pivotal one for both teams as they get ready for the postseason. And I think it'll be a pretty good matchup. I think Jay County is probably a better team than we give them credit for.
Yeah, definitely. Similar to last week's game between Leo and Belmont, that was kind of a third-place game in the NE8. This is kind of a third-place game for the ACAC. Obviously, those two teams fighting behind Adams Central and Woodland in the standings. So here we go again. Now, we're moving on. You're going to be at the Battle of the Bishops on Friday.
Yep.
Lucky you. Like you going over to Lewis Field. I think they're having some food trucks over there. So your credentials.
No matter what the game is, it always smells like football when you get to Lewis. And I mean that in a good way.
Yeah.
They've got great concession food and everything else over there.
Definitely. We may probably our first real cool night, first football weather night probably on Friday night. Hopefully the rain stays.
Yeah, we're getting there. We're getting to where it's football season. That's
yeah, definitely.
Sure.
We'll have you covered all weekend long. Again, live chat on Friday night. Scores, standings online. Reggie will have you cover from the Battle of the Bishops. I'll be at Carroll Homestead. We'll cover North and South as well throughout the weekend. Vote for Player of the Week, all the roundups. And then we'll wrap it up on Monday with our local notes and see kind of the news and notes that slip through the cracks over the weekend. So week seven, come down to an exciting week eight and week nine coming up, but an exciting week seven in itself coming up on Friday. Reggie Hayes, I'm Justin Kenny. Thanks for joining us.